Chapter 2. Self-realization. Sanjaya.
These are the words that Sri Krishna spoke to the despairing Arjuna, whose eyes were burning with tears of pity and confusion.
Krishna. This despair and weakness in a time of crisis are mean and unworthy of you, Arjuna. How have you fallen into a state so far from the path to liberation? It does not become you to yield to this weakness. Arise with a brave heart and destroy the enemy.
Arjuna, how can I ever bring myself to fight against Bhishma and Drona, who are worthy of reverence? How can I, Krishna? Surely it would be better to spend my life begging than to kill these great and worthy souls. If I killed them, every pleasure I found would be tainted. I don't even know which would be better, for us to conquer them or for them to conquer us.
The sons of Dhritarashtra have confronted us. But why would we care to live if we killed them?
My will is paralyzed, and I am utterly confused. Tell me which is the better path for me. Let me be your disciple. I have fallen at your feet. Give me instruction. What can overcome a sorrow that saps all my vitality? Even power over men and gods or the wealth of an empire seem empty.
Sanjaya.
This is how Arjuna, the great warrior, spoke to Sri Krishna. With the words, O Krishna, I will not fight. He fell silent. As they stood between the two armies, Sri Krishna smiled and replied to Arjuna, who had sunk into despair.
Krishna, you speak sincerely, but your sorrow has no cause. The wise grieve neither for the living nor the dead. There has never been a time when you and I and the kings gathered here have not existed, nor will there be a time when we will cease to exist. As the same person inhabits the body through childhood, youth, and old age, so too at the time of death he attains another body. The wise are not deluded by these changes. When the senses contact sense objects, a person experiences cold or heat, pleasure or pain. These experiences are fleeting. They come and go. Bear them patiently, Arjuna. Those who are unaffected by these changes, who are the same in pleasure and pain, are truly wise and fit for immortality. Assert your strength and realize this. The impermanent has no reality. Reality lies in the eternal. Those who have seen the boundary between these two have attained the end of all knowledge. Realize that which pervades the universe and is indestructible. No power can affect this unchanging, imperishable reality. The body is mortal, but that which dwells in the body is immortal and immeasurable. Therefore, Arjuna, fight in this battle.